Hi there, it's me again, Naveen with Naveen's Cuisine. And today we're doing a little bit of a French cuisine. So I'm making a dish called pomme en croûte, which means pomme in French means apples. En croûte means in a blanket, and the blanket is puff pastry. You can either make it yourself, but I like to get Pepperidge Farm frozen sheets. It takes a few minutes, maybe 10 minutes to keep out to the frost. Put a little bit of flour on the board and on top of the pastry. What I'm doing is I'm stretching it a little bit because I'm using a whole wheel of Brie. And you can use bigger sheets or combine two sheets if you want to make a bigger size Brie, but I'm using this size. And I buy my Brie from Costco, the Kirkland brand is as good as any. So basically I'm trying to size it up so when I fold everything over I have enough pastry to go over. So we're gonna stretch it just a tad more. This makes for a great get-together appetizer. It could also be used as a dessert with a glass of wine, with a glass of champagne. Christmas time is around the corner and it's a great way to celebrate with family and friends. So basically I have it rolled out and I'm putting the Brie cheese in the center. And I have about a quarter cup packed brown sugar that I'm gonna be putting right on top of it, kind of press it in the cheese. If some fall along on the side, that's fine. And I've sliced some green apples. You can use any kind of apples, but green is nice and tart and it goes really well with the, it's a nice offset for the brown sugar. You slice it thin with the peel on. If you don't like the peel, you can always peel it off, no problem. Kind of overlap as such. Very easy to make. You can sprinkle a little bit of dried cranberries on it. You can put raisins if you feel like. You can do different types of Brie en croûte, savory or sweet. This one is a sweet kind. You can also make it with pesto and sun-dried tomatoes. You can get very creative with that. Use some dried cranberries and you can add some nuts to it. Walnuts, pecan, almonds. I so happen to have some sliced almonds, so I'm gonna add that to it. Then we're gonna slowly bring the edges over. As such, brushing off the excess flour. I'm kind of folding it over like such. And on the top you can make yourself a nice little rosette. You're pulling all the sides of the pastry over. Get it nice and pinched in the center. And voila, you have a little rosette going on. You get an egg, mix it up with some water, and brush it on top until everything is covered with the egg wash. Now you can bake it right away, or you can wait till about an hour before your guests arrive. Bake it, and put it on a platter with some sides to it, because once you start cutting into the brie is gonna be melted and all over the place. So kind of try to pick a dish or a platter that has sides, put it in the center, and serve with sliced baguette. Because once it's out, and once you start cutting in the cheese and the apples, everything is gonna start oozing, and it's so nice to scoop it out with sliced baguette or crackers or any other bread of your choice. Since I don't have any get-togethers today, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna be wrapping it in plastic really well and freezing it. That way it's ready anytime I have guests, maybe for Thanksgiving, waiting for my family. So here it is. En croûte, brie en croûte, and this one is apple, so it's palm en croûte. Don't forget to visit me on YouTube, Yvine's Cuisine. Bon appétit!